إن الحمد لله تعالى نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونؤمن به ونتوكل عليه ونعوذ بالله تعالى من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا إنه من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له جل عن الشبيه والمثيل والكفء والند والنظير وأشهد أن محمدًا عبده ورسوله وصفيه وخليله وخيرته من خلقه وأمينه على وحيه أرسله ربه رحمة للعالمين وحجة على العباد أجمعين فهدى الله تعالى به من الضلالة وبصر به من الجهالة وكثر به بعد القلة وأغنى به بعد العيلة ولم به بعد الشتات وأمن به بعد الخوف وصلوات الله وسلامه عليه وعلى آله الطيبين وأصحابه الغر الميامين ما اتصلت عين بنظر ووعت أذن بخبر وسلم تسليما كثيرا أما بعد أيها الإخوة الكرام أوصيكم ونفسي بتقوى الله في السر والعلن فإن الله جل وعلا أمرنا بالتقوى كما جاء في سورة آل عمران يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون وفي بداية سورة النساء يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا وفي نهاية سورة الأحزاب يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما فإن أصدق الحديث كتاب الله تعالى وخير الهدى هدى رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم وشر الأمور محدثاتها وكل محدثة بدعة وكل بدعة ضلالة وكل ضلالة في النار أعاذنا الله منها جميعا Respected brothers and sisters in Islam, quite often when it comes to the practicing of Islam, we forget one aspect, that is memorization of the ahadith of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So much so that our emphasis on memorization of the verses of Allah from the Quran, whether it is from the end or from the beginning, or let's say even the whole Quran, it really neglects the idea that there are ahadith that need to be memorized. Now there are greater rewards also when it comes to memorizing the ahadith of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam, not greater than the verses of the Quran, of course. Why? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created all of us. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the one who sent all the prophets and messengers to follow His sharia, shari'atullah. And the last sharia of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that He has chosen for us, O servants of Allah, al-Islam. In Surah Al-Imran, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says that إِنَّ الدِّينَ عِنْدَ اللَّهِ الْإِسْلَامِ Indeed, to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the only acceptable religion is al-Islam. The only way of life is al-Islam. And of course, regarding Islam, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in Surah Al-Ma'idah, which is the fifth chapter of the Quran, on the third verse, He says, اليوم أكملت لكم دينكم وأتممت عليكم نعمتي ورضيت لكم الإسلام دينا. Today, indeed, I have perfected for you your religion, your way of life that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has chosen for us. وَأَتْمَمْتُ عَلَيْكُمْ نِعْمَتِي I am also completed upon you the ni'mah, my ni'mah, my bounties. وَرَضِيتُ لَكُمُ الْإِسْلَامَ دِينًا And I have chosen for you al-Islam as the way of life, as Islam, as the way of everything that we must do. Hence, when it comes to al-Islam, O servants of Allah, when we try to cling ourselves or attach ourselves to the deen of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, there is nothing called pick and choose. There is nothing called that I can take this and I can ignore that. Islam, wholeheartedly, if we need to follow, then we must follow. There is no yes, but if so. Hence, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam mentioned in a hadith that is recorded as a hasan hadith. And we know, it also it is recorded, Shaykh al-Albani, he graded this hadith as hasan. Imam Muslim rahmatullahi alayhi graded this hadith as sahih, where Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, طَلَبُ الْعِلْمِ فَرِيضَةٌ عَلَى كُلِّ مُسْلِمٍ Seeking knowledge is an obligation or a fard upon every Muslim. From the time of being baligh all the way to death. the person should learn the knowledge of Al-Islam. Regarding the memorization of the Ahadith or servants of Allah, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said in a hadith that نَضَّرَ اللَّهُ عَبْدًا سَمِعَ مَقَالَتِي فَوَعَاهَا وَحَفِظَهَا ثُمَّ أَدَّاهَا إِلَى مَنْ لَمْ يَسْمَعْهَا فَرُبَّ حَامِلٍ فِقْهٍ لَا فِقْهَ لَهُ وَرُبَّ حَامِلٍ فِقْهٍ إِلَى مَنْ هُوَ أَفْقَهُ مِنْهُ. This hadith, O servants of Allah, is recorded by Imam Abu Dawood, Imam al-Tirmidhi, Ibn Majah, and Musnad of Imam Ahmad. And Shaykh al-Albani rahmatullahi alayhi rendered this hadith as sahih. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam commanded us to memorize hadith. He said, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala illuminate his face, illuminate the face of the one who hears my saying, maqalati, and memorizes it by heart, then he conveys it to the person who did not hear it. Perhaps a person who carries this speech has no understanding of its meaning, and maybe the person carries this hadith to a person who understands it better. O servants of Allah, this is the reward from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala we will receive. And this is the dua for those who memorize the ahadith. Now regarding the hadith of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, talabul ilmi faridatun ala kulli muslim. When it comes to the knowledge of servants of Allah, knowledge is something that is a command from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that we need to seek. And first and foremost, when it comes to seeking knowledge, is to know about Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. In Surah Muhammad, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentions, it is in the 26th juz of the Quran, after Surah Al-Ahqaf, before Surah Al-Fath, Surah Muhammad. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala commands every believing person, whether man or woman, even the jinn kind are commanded to follow this. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, fa'lam, and know. So the word know is the part word of the word knowledge in English. So when it comes to seeking knowledge, this is the first thing that we need to do. Fa'lam, annahu la ilaha illallah. Know that there is no deity worthy of worship. So when we know about Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, when we know about Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's rububiyyah, when we know about the uluhiyyah of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, when we know about the names and attributes of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that are known as al-asma wa sifat, the way that the sahaba radiallahu anhum understood from the Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the final prophet of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the seal of all prophet, later on, seeking knowledge about other parts relevant to the lifestyle of a Muslim become easier. Part of knowing Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is to know who Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was, what he brought to us, what he showed us, what he said, what he approved of. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the first and foremost the one who should be known by us, the way that the Sahaba radiallahu anhum ajma'in learned from Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam about Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Then comes the verses of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, because when it comes to fulfilling the rights of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, after La ilaha illallah Muhammad Rasulullah comes the second pillar of Islam, As-Salah. Of course, in the Salah, we are bound to recite or read the verses of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So when we read the verses of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, it connects us also with the Sunnah of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. How? Through the a'mal of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the way that Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam prayed. What were the obligatory things that he did during the prayer? What were the requirements before Salah and after the Salah and within the Salah? So these are the things, O servants of Allah, the more we come to the Quran, the more we know about Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala through the actions of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, it would be easier to worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وما كان المؤمنون لينفروا كافة فلولا نفر من كل فرقة منهم طائفة ليتفقهوا في الدين ولينذروا قومهم إذا رجعوا إليهم لعلهم يحذرون. It is not for the believers to go forward all at once to take the field in the time of war. For there should separate from every division of them a group, meaning the remaining group, devoted to obtaining deeper understanding in the religion of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and warn. وَلِيُنذِرُوا قَوْمَهُمْ and warn the people, or advise the people rather, so when they return to them, they might guard themselves against evil. This is in Surah At-Tawbah chapter 9, verse 122, Allah mentions this. So seeking knowledge of servants of Allah has an obligation, has a reward of it. The more we seek knowledge, the more we become humble, the more we attain humility. Without humility, there would be nothing. If we do not make ourselves humble by seeking knowledge of servants of Allah, then that knowledge would become something opposite to it. It would make you fruitless. Maybe in the dunya you will have whatever you desire through the knowledge, where people would say, MashaAllah, Tabarakallah, he is someone who is knowledgeable. But in the eyes of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, it is other way around. Why? If we look at the Salaf al-Saleh, if we look at the Sahaba first and foremost, then the Tabi'een and Atba' al-Tabi'een, and those who still cling towards these three generations, we see them, that the more they acquired knowledge, the more they were closer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the more they would shed tears so that they don't become arrogant, so that it doesn't become a showing off scenario. When it comes to seeking knowledge of servants of Allah, we need to have an open heart. We need to have a sincere intention so that this knowledge benefits us rather than cursing us. The knowledge of Islam or servants of Allah will not degrade you. The knowledge of Islam or servants of Allah will uphold you. The knowledge of Islam or servants of Allah will give you the dunya, the goodness in the dunya as well as the goodness in the akhirah. That is something, O servants of Allah, we need to achieve as much as possible. That is something, O servants of Allah, we need to teach our next generation. That is something, O servants of Allah, the more we practice, the more our next generations will adhere to. And they would make dua for you, servants of Allah, when they grow older. And that is a legacy that Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam left for the Sahaba. The Sahaba radiallahu anhum ajma'in left for the Tabi'een. The Tabi'een rahimahumullah left for the Atba' al-Tabi'een. The Atba' al-Tabi'een rahimahumullah left for the later generation. And that is something that we try to attain the knowledge from. As the hadith of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam goes, خير الناس قرني ثم الذين يلونهم ثم الذين يلونهم. The best of the mankind are the people who are of my generation, referring to the Sahaba. ثم الذين يلونهم, then those who follow the Sahaba. ثم الذين يلونهم, then those who follow the followers of the Sahaba. تابعين أتباع التابعين. نفعني الله وإياكم بما فيه من الآيات والذكر الحكيم وبهدي سيد المرسلين أقول ما تسمعون وأستغفر الله لي ولكم ولسائر المسلمين من كل ذنب فاستغفروه وتوبوا إليه إنه هو التواب الرحيم إنه هو الغفور الرحيم. الحمد لله الحمد لله على إحسانه وشكر له على توفيقه وامتنانه وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له تعظيما لشأنه وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله الداعي إلى رضوانه صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وصحبه ومن تبعهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين. اللهم لا علم لنا إلا ما علمتنا إنك أنت العليم الحكيم. اللهم علمنا ما ينفعنا وانفعنا بما علمتنا يا رب العالمين. The servants of Allah, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam said, "Man yuridillahu bihi khayran yufaqihu fi al-deen." Whoever Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala intends good for, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gives him an understanding in the religion of Islam. This hadith of servants of Allah is recorded by Ibn Majah rahmatullahi alayh, and Imam al-Tirmidhi rahmatullahi alayh also recorded it in his Sunan. Shaykh al-Albani rahmatullahi alayh classed this hadith as sahih. The hadith was narrated by Abu Hurairah radiallahu ta'ala anhu. Abu Hurairah radiallahu ta'ala anhu, the one who narrated the most of the hadith of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, more than 5,000 hadith. Then comes Ummul Mu'mineen Aisha bint Abi Bakr as-Siddiq radiallahu ta'ala anhuma. Then comes Abdullah ibn Umar, Abdullah ibn Abbas, Anas bin Malik, all these companions. One thing they had in common, that they were always with Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Abu Hurairah, the one who was struggling to memorize the ahadith of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and he was from those who are of Ahlul Sufa. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam made dua for Abu Hurairah. And later on, Allah blessed Abu Hurairah radiallahu ta'ala anhu with the memorization and most of the hadith that come from Abu Hurairah radiallahu ta'ala anhu. This is the hadith. Imam Al-Ajurri rahimahullahu ta'ala commented, "This hadith indicates that whosoever does not gain an understanding in his religion, then there is no good in him." In order for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to want us be used for something that is good, we want to take a step forward. We are given a free will after the good and evil being made clear to us. When the evil is chosen by us, then we are dooming ourselves. When the goodness is chosen by us, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will protect you. We need to strive for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's mercy. We need to strive for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's tawfiq. We need to be sincere when we are striving for something that we need from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, along with the sincerity. So if we want to practice al-Islam after the understanding of the verses of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, after the understanding of what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wants from us, along with the sunnah of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, then we need to sincerely ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's tawfiq. Or else, as the author of this book, Imam Al-Ajurri rahimahullah ta'ala, mentions that it is an indication that when someone does not gain the understanding of an Islam the way the person should understand from the Salaf al-Saleh, then the person has no khair in him. We do not want to be in that scenario where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will totally separate the people of having no khair from those who have khair. We would rather want to be with the people who have khair. We would rather want to attain Jannah. We would rather want to be on the positive ending in the Akhirah when it comes to seeking Jannah from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Another hadith of servants of Allah, it is worth mentioning. It is narrated by Abu Umama al-Bahili radiallahu ta'ala anhu. He said that Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, "Alaykum bil ilmi qabla an yuqbad wa qabla an yurfa thumma jama'a bayna usba'ayhi al-wusta wallati talihi al-ibham thumma qal al-alim wal-muta'allim sharikani fil ajr wa la khayrun fil nasi ba'd." It is upon you to seek knowledge before it is seized and lifted. Then he joined his middle finger, index finger, and his thumb. At that time, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam said, "The alim, the scholar, and the person who seeks knowledge, al-muta'allim, both share in the reward. There is not a better well-being in the people after this." Ibn Abdul Barr, rahimahullah ta'ala, recorded this hadith in Jami' al-Bayan al-Ilm. Ibn Majah rahmatullahi alayhi is also recorded this hadith. And Shaykh Al-Albani rahmatullahi alayhi also graded this hadith. Now, we are seeing in the last 1400 years, the people who benefited from the scholars that were proclaiming and that were teaching the people to preserve the religion of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, they were sincere. As those who were not sincere, as for those who were not sincere, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala humiliated them. Even when it comes to seekers of knowledge or servants of Allah, they were also sincere when they were seeking the knowledge from the scholars of Al-Islam. Bearing in mind, the servants of Allah, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will preserve the Quran until the day of resurrection. Along with it, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will preserve the Islam, the religion that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has chosen for us. All of us are servants of Allah, my brothers and sisters, we are just passing by. The life span that were given for us, between 60 to 80 years, we're just passing by. Islam would be something that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will protect until the day of Qiyamah. It is up to us whether we are coming to the religion of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, al-Islam. It is up to us whether we are begging for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to forgive us, to shower us with His mercy, to sustain us, to give us the sincerity, to give us tawfiq, to do something that is always good. Because we are in need of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is not in need of us. No wonder why, when the lesser we turn to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the more we fall into the evil deeds, the more we doom ourselves. So much so that we are not even realizing that it would lead us to the eternal hell, where we would be there for eternity. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala protect us all from the fire in the hell. Ameen. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us tawfiq to come back to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala the way that we need to come back, the way that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala need to be followed, the way that sunnah of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam need to be followed. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forgive all our sins. Allahumma ameen. Ibadallah, i'lamu anna Allah amarakum bis salatu was salam ala nabiyyi wa qala fi muhkam at-tanzil inna Allah wa malaikatahu yusalluna ala nabiy ya ayyuhalladhina amanu sallu alayhi wa sallimu taslima. وعن أنس بن مالك رضي الله عنه أن النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم قال من صلى عليه صلاة واحدة صلى الله عليه عشر صلوات وحط عنه عشر خطيئات. رواه الإمام أحمد في مسنده. فصلوا وسلموا على سيد الأولين والآخرين. اللهم صل على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما صليت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم في العالمين إنك حميد مجيد. وبارك على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما باركت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم في العالمين إنك حميد مجيد. ورضى اللهم عن خلفاء الراشدين الأئمة المهديين الذين قضوا بالحق وبه كانوا يعدلون أبي بكر وعمر وعثمان وعلي وعن سائر الصحابة أجمعين وعنا معهم بعفوك ومنك وكرمك يا أكرم الأكرمين. اللهم أعز الإسلام والمسلمين. اللهم أعز الإسلام والمسلمين. اللهم أعز الإسلام والمسلمين وذل الكفر والكافرين وانصر عبادك المؤمنين المستضعفين في كل بلدان المسلمين يا رب العالمين. اللهم كن للمستضعفين عونا وظهيرا وهيئ لهم من لدنك وليا ونصيرا. اللهم عليك باليهود المعتدين وسائر الكفرة الظالمين. اللهم اقذف الرعب في قلوبهم وأنزل بهم بأسك الذي لا يرد عن القوم المجرمين. يا قوي يا عزيز ربنا ظلمنا أنفسنا وإن لم تغفر لنا وترحمنا لنكونن من الخاسرين. ربنا أتمم لنا نورنا واعف عنا فاغفر لنا ذنوبنا وكفر عنا سيئاتنا وتوفنا مع الأبرار. ربنا اغفر لنا ذنوبنا وإسرافنا في أمرنا وثبت أقدامنا وانصرنا على القوم الكافرين وانصرنا على القوم المشركين وانصرنا على القوم المنافقين. عباد الله رحمكم الله إن الله يأمر بالعدل والإحسان وإيتاء ذي القربى وأنهى عن الفحشاء والمنكر والبغي يعظكم لعلكم تذكرون. فاذكروا الله العظيم الجليل يذكركم واشكروه على نعمه يزدكم ولذكر الله تعالى أكبر وأجل. وأقم الصلاة.